My name is Maggie McCammon, and I'm a research translation specialist at the University of Michigan, and that involves translating academic discoveries from the laboratory into the marketplace. So we're trying to commercialise the discoveries that our academic scientists make. Well, I was an academic researcher myself for a while. I was a postdoc and then a research fellow at the University of Cambridge. And what I found was that there was a lot of absolutely cutting-edge, fantastic research coming out. But the scientists kind of fell down when it came to taking the next step, as in getting it out of the test tube into a tablet or an injection that you could put into someone that will actually make a difference to someone who's ill or whatever. So I became interested in what the next step would be, how we could encourage our scientists to do that. And then I did the MBA at Cambridge University at the Judge Business School, and I focused on commercialising academic discoveries. And so we looked at lots of different ways, lots of different pathways and new ideas, working with large pharma companies and things like that. And at the end of the MBA, I decided that that's the area I wanted to go into rather than going back to the research bench. And that sort of job doesn't really seem to exist in the UK at the moment. And it's definitely a growing area. The research councils are all have put huge resources into this, and they have technology transfer departments of their own. And I've contacted the people that are involved in these, and they're very open and they're very keen to look at new ways of doing it. It's quite a new area, but it's enormously interesting, and there's a lot of funding going into it. I thought I wanted to be an academic researcher all the way through. It didn't occur to me that I'd leave the bench. And the sort of turning point, I think, was I was working on a project in a big collaboration, and we found that we'd got some really good results, and I was thinking in terms of clinical trials and things, because I had an industry background before that. And then I found out that other people in the collaboration were still thinking in terms of academic research, and I think that's the main part when I realised that that there's a disjoin, that there's a gap between the academic scientist and actually translating that into a product or a real thing on the market. While I was doing my degree, I worked unpaid in different industry settings, and one of them, Pfizer, is the place I decided where I really needed to do a PhD. There was an older chap there. He hadn't done a PhD, but he was fantastically brilliant. He absolutely knew everything. And he took me aside quite early on and said his biggest regret was that he didn't do a PhD, and there's a definite glass ceiling, certainly within industry and also within academia, I realise now, if you don't have a PhD. And he'd missed his chance, and when he realised that, he'd already had a family and mortgage, and he didn't have the option to go back. So while I was at Pfizer, that's when I first started thinking about I wanted to go on and do a PhD. It's not really been a journey. What I've always done is what I want to do. I don't want to do a job that I don't like, or I don't want to get stuck in something that I'm not enjoying. I like the idea of blue sky research, although I realise that there needs to be a commercial aspect because it's so expensive. My job is going to be interacting with academic scientists, trying to convince them that they want to buy into the idea of commercialising their research, which is really difficult. By definition, world-class scientists tend to be very focused, almost to the point of being obsessed. And what we don't want them to do is lose focus to try and start commercialising their work. We need them to stay, you know, world-class. Because I've been in a research academic, I know the pressures they're under, I understand how they think, I understand the vernacular, I think I can interact with them on a more one-to-one basis, or a more sort of trusting basis, I suppose. And the job I'm doing now is my absolute dream job, it's perfect. In fact, I virtually wrote the job description and then sort of touted it around trying to get someone to give me a job doing it, which Michigan did.